What is up, everybody? Welcome to this week's Jesse Spec YouTube video. Today is an important episode because we're diving into the Kswap of my Mr2 Spyder, and today we're gonna actually, before taking the engine out of the car, we're actually gonna do a compression test and a general health check of the engine. So this can be really useful for any of you guys who are actually looking for a donor car like I did, for example, an EP3, to get the K engine out of it. You can actually watch this video and see how to check the engine before actually removing it from the car and make your work worthwhile, basically. So I hope this is gonna be useful for all of you, and let's dive right into it. Join me. Back in the office, or should I say in the warehouse, and today is the first step of swapping a K series, so K20A2, into an Mr2 Spyder. Sorry, I'm a bit tired because it's an early morning thing, and anyway, so let's get hyped up and do this. So before doing anything, that's my first advice, is first of all, on top of this is an accident car, so there can be some dodgy things going on. So let's just compression test the car, the engine, before actually taking everything apart, you know, just to have a good feeling. And also, you know, it's easier to take apart a car knowing that everything is already working and fine. And especially if you want to take some shortcuts, make sure you know what you're doing. But at least, you know, the engine has good compressions. So pistons and even head cover and everything, all the head and the valves and everything should be in pretty good condition. And that gives you really a better starting point. And also, I would probably give back the car if I realized the engine was totally worn down with no compression. So let's take a look at it. That's Tim arriving. He's a Honda tech. Big shout out to him. Many thanks for helping me, buddy. Also, what's important to mention is do your compression tests when the engine is totally cold. Mine hasn't run for like 2 weeks, so that's going to be perfect. I also got a compression tester. Looks like this. It's a really cheap one, but it will probably work just fine. Like this. And then you have basically the indications. You can use adapters according to the spark plugs you're using, and yeah. So let's give it a try.
So the first step is to remove, of course, that gray plastic cover over the spark plugs so we can access the spark plugs. You have to remove the spark plugs in order to do a compression test. And there's another thing that is really important that you have to keep in mind when you're doing compression tests is you should prevent gasoline to be injected once you turn the engine over on the starter motor while measuring your compression rates, because the danger of that is that you will actually have gasoline that will be injected during the time the engine is not starting, and that can actually be a really detrimental thing because you're actually having gasoline injected into the cylinders that can be in quite a large quantity. But on top of that, you're sort of rinsing and cleaning the cylinders out, which means that once you start the engine, you will actually end up having problems like that, and it will actually destroy your engine. So be really careful. Here you saw, I just removed that plastic cover. That's just to make the access to the injectors easier. And we're gonna do a really simple way, is just unplug the injectors, even though it will make an engine fault code. But in the end, it's no big deal because we're just gonna check the compression rates, and then we'll see how they are, and we'll go from there. Here you see, this is my own dumbness letting a screw drop exactly where it's difficult, and I managed to pull it out anyway. But anyway, so let's take a look at that and do these compression tests, remove the injectors, and let's see if this engine is healthy or not. So we're removing the spark plugs now. I didn't say that before, but we of course removed all the coil packs as well that were held with a 10 mil screw. And now we're just pulling them out one by one using a magnet as well.
Okay, so we need to remove all the spark coils, and Tim is removing the spark plugs as well. And make sure to disconnect the injectors, otherwise you will have your cylinders full of gasoline, which is not a good idea. So let's do this.
Little pro tip here for you guys who have like a broken spark plug socket, or you don't have one with a magnet inside. A little easy thing and trick you can do to pull out spark plugs easier once they're unscrewed is using a little magnet like I'm doing right here. And this actually makes things much easier.
Spark plugs look pretty old, to be honest. Tim just told me that if you have like brown below the thing here, that probably means that they weren't changed in a long time.
So as you can see, I bought a little booster here, a really tiny one. I'm very skeptical of these things, and actually many people, fellow mechanics as well, tell me that they've done huge progress in quality departments. So let's see if we can do the compression tests, and we're going to try with the long shaft, see if we can actually access it well, and let's go from there and see how the compression is.
Okay, so we're going to try the compression test now.
First fail. So my booster wasn't fully charged, first of all, but also I didn't know that you had to actually push on the little button that activates the boost function, basically. So here you can enjoy both of us trying to figure out what is the problem, and actually we ended up figuring it out right now.
25,000 la bagnole. T'es prêt?
Tout tu es. Vas-y.
According to Tim, there seems to be only 8 bar compression. It seems low, but also on the other hand, we're a bit skeptical if this tube system is actually sealing off the compression correctly. So let's give it a try with the other system and see if it works better.
On va essayer avec l'autre système.
Ok, ready?
Il reste à voir.
Don't forget to push on the boost button.
Ah, il faut appuyer sur quel bouton?
Boost.
Boost. Boost!
T'es prêt?
Vas-y. C'est bon. Bah c'est mieux, il a 12 bars là.
12?
Aha, okay, much bon. Better. We have 12 bars. Bon. That seems good. According to Tim, they say between 10 and 11 bar is a healthy engine for the K20. So we're doing really good here.
Ouais. Oui, c'est super.
Top. Alors, on start la machine. OK, ready?
Ça va faire là?
Je crois, ouais. OK, prêt?
Vas-y.
Awesome. We're also a little bit less, between 11.5 and 12 bar. That is really good. We're getting our compressions on point. Cylinder 1 and 2 seem to be coherent and having good compression.
Honda, tu...
Je sais pas, normalement c'est autour de 10, 11. Hein.
Ok.
Donc 12, c'est vraiment bien.
Ok.
Après, est-ce que ce machin est vraiment fiable?
Oui, ça c'est l'autre question.
There is also one point that we are not always sure, since this is a relatively cheap compression tool. It might actually be a little bit imprecise, but on the other hand, if we actually get similar values between all the cylinders, that can actually confirm that they are all similar at least, which is a good starting point. I honestly am willing to trust this machine, even though it's a little bit a cheap one, but on the other hand, I mean, yeah, there you can feel that the car has compression, and there is definitely at least 10 bars, so that's a really good starting point. Perfect. Again, 11.5 on this cylinder. We see that at least the first three cylinders are very close to one another. With all this beautiful language, we're gonna do the fourth cylinder, hoping that we have no bad surprises on the last one, which I highly doubt. Also here we see that the booster ran out of energy again, so we just unplugged it and put it back on, hoping that we will actually be able to start it with the last energy that's left in it, and it seems to be okay, so let's do it. Perfect, so we have 11.5 on the last cylinder. So basically, if I summarize it, we had 12 on cylinder 1, 11.5, 11.5, and 11.5 on the last cylinders. So we see that we're above what is required, and that is really good news.
Tim had a good idea. We're just gonna put a camera inside, since I had to use one for my stupid 2ZZ blown engine. And let's see if there's anything weird to see inside before we actually go further into taking the engine apart. So it looks like that some of the cylinders are a bit dark, but that can be due to the fact that first of all, two of them were up higher and it looked like a lot of soot on it. But actually, when we look at the two middle ones, it seemed pretty normal. So honestly, the engine looks healthy from a compression rate and also from a calamine status, it looks pretty okay. So we're gonna start the engine, make sure it runs perfectly, and then we'll start dropping the engine.
Okay.
Okay, so at this point, it's time to put everything back together, or at least a big part of it, because we're anyway going to be taking everything apart later when we're doing the engine. So anyway, put the spark plugs back in, put the coil packs back in as well. Important thing with spark plugs, no need to tighten them too hard. Also, as you can see, I screwed them in by hand at first in order to prevent cross-threading the cylinder head, because that's actually something that happens pretty often. So as you can see, there's only very minimal effort needed to actually tighten the spark plugs. It's like 25 newton meters. So with one hand, no need to use the whole leverage of the socket to actually tighten it. Here we put back in the coil plugs. Also, do not forget to plug in the injectors again, and then we should be able to give the engine a start. Of course, open the door, make sure you do not inhale too much exhaust fumes, because we all know how that ends up. So anyway, booster back on, hopefully it has enough energy, and let's try to start this engine for the first time since I've owned it.
Ready, go. Ah, il a l'air de bien tourner quand même, hein. All right, the engine seems to run right. So now we can start taking the engine out. So next video will be on how to take the engine out of a EP3 chassis. And Tim is gonna help us today. So let's do this. So I hope you enjoyed this video. As you can see, the EP3 I chose has a really healthy engine with between 11 and 12 bar compression. There's no oil leaks, the engine runs flawlessly. So we can actually now get into the removal of the engine, which is next week's video, and Tim is again going to be on board helping us, so big shout out to him. Many thanks to him. He's really not only a funny guy, but a really good Honda mechanic, I must say. And we really make a good team, so I'm really happy to have him on board. And if you like this video, make sure to like, subscribe, ask questions in the comments. I'm happy to answer them, of course, if they're within reasonable boundaries. So thank you so much for watching this week, and you can look forward to next week because we're gonna rip the engine out of the EP3. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Peace.